joke. 911 is a joke. Finally. Well, it's about time, Turner and Hooch.
Excuse me?
I called y'all an hour ago.
What's the problem, sir?
Get inside and I'll tell you. Okay. Thank you for joining me. Here's what happened. I went outside to get a sandwich. I come back, my door's wide open, all my weed is gone.
I'm sorry, did you say all your weed is gone?
Come on, Crockett. Don't tell me you don't know what weed is, man. Pot, reefer, marijuana.
Yes, we know what it is.
All right, well then quit dorking me around here, Tubbs. I'm a man who's been robbed it. All right, they took 3 choice blunt bushes and 8 ounces I harvested last weekend, all right? So go, get on the case, Jake and the Fat Man, and let's go.
Right. You know we're police officers, right?
What? I don't even understand what's happening here. The dudes that stole my weed is getting away, and I'm talking to the cops right here.
All right, sir, why don't you just tell us what happened?
All right, thank you, Cagney. All right, Lacey over here trying to jack me around, but I can see that you with it. All right, so last night, I was at the Blue Rose, all right? I shut it down, got rail drunk, all right? I decided to drive back to my place for a little after hours party. You know what I'm talking about?
you drove drunk.
Catch up, Starsky, all right? Hutch over here, he got a little pad out. He gonna be writing down cop things. What you doing?
What's your name?
Melvin Dufresne, that's D-U-F-R-A-N-E. People call me Mello Mel. At this point, I'm in my car, right? And all of a sudden, I lose control. I do a nose plant into a bus stop, decide to ditch the vehicle, set it on fire, 2 tears in a bucket. You know what I'm talking about, Poncherello. At this point, I make it back to my pad where the party's already happening, right here. And let me tell you, it's a white Christmas. If you know what I mean. If you know what I mean.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, thank you for joining us, Tonto. Lone Ranger and I, we was having a discussion about a crime that happened. It's nice to see you here. Yes, I was doing cocaine. All right, most I've ever done. And everybody in this piece was talking over one another, right? We watching a bootleg copy of the Anne Boleyn girl. And this one girl, she trying to leave, right? She starts screaming, we wouldn't let her. Instead, we slip her some GHB, right? Put her out on the fire escape. She could be there still, I do not know. At this point, I go out to get my sandwich, which I stole because I ain't got no money. When I come back inside, that's when my weed was stolen. So, there it is, McGruff the crime dog, Scooby don't. Let's get on the case, sniff out some perps. What, why are you not left yet?
Let me just make sure I got this straight. You got drunk and crashed a car.
Set it on fire.
Right. Then you snorted some cocaine.
Most I've ever done.
You held a girl against her will.
Who was screaming.
And you stole a sandwich, is that about right?
Listening to a single word I've been saying?
Okay, sir. Right. Well, what we're gonna do, we're gonna arrest you now because everything you've described is illegal.
What you talking about, man? Oh, no, no. Oh, don't. Come on, man. This is ridiculous. What? I called you. I called y'all. Oh, all right. Yeah, welcome to Bush's America. Seen it before, been there, done that. All right, whoa, hold up, Judge Dredd, Rob Snyder's character. Hold on 1 second. What if I had information about a murder?
Well, you know, we could probably knock some of this down if you had information about a murder.
Cuffs, please. Would it hurt or help me if I was the murderer in question?
It would definitely hurt.
Okay, you better just lock me up for that other stuff then. Yeah, I am the stupidest man in the world. Am I not?